And so as we consider this notion of coven, I'd like to ask the confirmants to step forward. Something that is a beginning, not an end. It's a start, not a completion. Do you promise to them and before God to continue to encourage them in their faith, to hold them accountable when you see them falling astray, to celebrate them when they are living into it in earnest, in joy, and in love? Do you yourselves remember your own commitment to God? And even step it up to provide the kind of example that will lead these young men too into adulthood as thriving, devoted, faithful servants of Jesus Christ. If so, say I will. Past year, you've taken time to learn about your church, the Methodist Church. You've taken time to learn about the scriptures. You've taken time to learn about what it means to serve, what it means to have fun together, what it means to be connected. And so I ask you, before these witnesses and before God, do you commit to spend your lives in pursuit of Christ? Do you vow to be the very best you can before God? To faithfully find the call that God has on your life and to live into it fully? To take the example of the people around you and when they pat you on the back, say thank you and smile with them? And if they correct you, say thank you and smile. And take it to heart. Do you commit to offering your gifts of service to this community of faith as you are part of it now? If so, say I will. You may not remember this, but when you were babies, pretty likely someone did something similar like this. We poured water in a basin. And they reminded your family and the other people that were gathered there of the promises of God. They used this water as a symbol of purity, of promise between God and humanity. And they asked your parents and the people gathered here if they would raise you in the faith so that one day you can claim that faith for yourself. That day is today. It's a great day. John Wesley, we talked about John Wesley a little bit. He had this understanding of grace, the gift of God that forgives us, directs us, strengthens us, and guides us. And he had this understanding of grace. He said there's one kind of grace that we have when we're a baby. He called it prevenient grace. And it's grace that forgives everything and continues to call us to Jesus, even when we don't really understand fully what we're being called to. But then he talked about another kind of grace. He called it justifying grace. And it's that moment where you are able to make the choice for yourself, where it's no longer just relying on your family, your friends, and your church to feed you and hold your hand as you go, but you standing up and saying, okay, I'm old enough. I'm going to claim Jesus for me, and I'm going to live that faithfully. Justifying grace, where you are made right before God, not because of the words of another, but because of your heart and your faith. Do you guys, each of you don't remember your baptismal vows, but are you prepared to make those same vows today for yourself? We remember your baptism and honor your commitment to Christ. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And here it's today we remember your baptism. And we honor your commitment to God and to Christ. In the name of the Father. Today we remember your baptism, and we honor your commitment to God and to Christ. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Something that I've asked these gentlemen to do, and I'm just going to ask you to go and turn to the microphone here. I ask them, as they are coming into this community of faith, of their own accord, I've asked each of them to prepare two statements. First is this: what do you appreciate about having been raised in this community of faith? And the second is, what is one gift of service that you will commit to offering to this community of faith in the coming year? Your first time, sorry. You got the water, you got the mic first.
I appreciate the church community and the fellowship I feel there. And I will help the church in whatever way I can.
Well, you got to give us something more specific than that, brother.
By helping out with Sunday school, ushering, reading.
Sounds good. You're welcome. Thank you, sir.
The thing I most appreciate about being raised in this congregation is that the church allows me to contribute during worship by reading scripture, playing piano, and participating in sacraments, including communion. One gift of service I would commit to offer to this congregation is I will share my musical talents by playing the preludes and special music when needed.
Something that they look forward to, and our church family is able to provide joy, laughs, and smiles to them every year. It feels good knowing that I can be a part of this. There are many opportunities that I will take full advantage of to help the church prosper. Some of these include helping with communion, ushering, and participating in the upcoming youth group, just to name a few. The past year has been extremely fun preparing for this day with the immersion group. I would like to congratulate the rest of my class and say thank you to Pastor Brent for leading me through this spiritual journey and making it enjoyable.
Thank you, gentlemen. If you wonder if what you do for our kids makes a difference and if it matters, there you go. Gentlemen, if you could please come back out here and stand along the front of you. It's almost time, guys. I turn around this way. I've got something to add. Jeez. As you guys go forward in your journey of faith, I want to encourage you. Sometimes churches will pass you a Bible. That's something that I'm sure you guys all have Bibles lying around your house. And oddly enough, what Bible you select can be a very personal decision. And it's something you should consider as you go forward as young men of faith. So I'm going to leave that to you and to your families. What the church is going to offer to you is this. It's called a Tree of Life box. On it is a tree representing the Tree of Life, Christ. As you go through your journey of faith, there are going to be moments where things are going to happen where you're going to feel God's presence incredibly, clearly, and profoundly. There are going to be people that you come across, there are going to be things that you do that you're going to want to remember for the rest of your days, because as you get taken back to that moment, it will remind you that God is real, that your relationship with Christ is real, and that is something that carries us, that carries you, lifts you up, brings you comfort when you're down, brings you hope when you feel like it's lost, brings you strength when you feel weak. And when you're feeling joyful, when you're feeling proud of something that you've done, is that warm smile that you feel on the inside saying, good job, man, well done. In those moments, you may find something. It may be a stone, it may be some kind of a trinket, it may be a letter that somebody writes you, a thank you note that somebody gives. If you look back on it, it's a representation of Christ, and it will bring you life. I want to encourage you to put that in this box and keep it. When you're feeling down and your faith is wavering a little bit, go back and pull those things out and let them remind you. You already have one little thing in here. It's one cross. My hope is that this will remind you of today. When you accepted Jesus Christ on your own, for yourself, and that the love that was poured out on the cross, the redemption that was paid for on the cross, is yours. Jump by your hands with me. Gracious God, today we commit these young men to you. As they have now committed themselves wholly, knowingly, to the cause of Christ, we pray your blessing upon them. We pray your strength upon them. We ask that you would inspire them and their families to continue to grow and participate in their faith. To be part of this body that represents Christ in this community, knowing that what we do here has a ripple effect that many times echoes around the world. We ask that they would feel the warmth in their hearts as you smile upon them this day. We ask that they would feel the love from this congregation and their families as we welcome them. Love them, guide them, and protect them as they move forward as men of faith. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Welcome these guys.